Hi and welcome back to Fuller's Figures. Today I want to take a look at this Mark II design weapons pack that I got from Big Bang Comics here in Dublin. I knew nothing about this company or even that this product existed, only for the Big Bang Comic email notification last week of what they had coming into stock. Now this company has weapons pack A and weapons pack B, and I decided to pick up weapons pack B and have a look at which you hear today. Now, I think we're all well aware of the frustrations of the accessories that come with the GI Joe classifieds. A couple of examples is this one that came with Duke. This is one of the ones that came with Gung Ho. And possibly one of the worst weapons we got for one of the best figures is the weapon we got with Beachhead here in the GI Joe classified line. Now, these had really been frustrating me, and what I had started to do was pick up cheap figures in the Euro store, which is a lot like the dollar store in America, and just paint them up myself to try and get a little more realistic kind of weapon for my figures for photographs. And that's okay, although sometimes the scale was out, and the funny thing is a lot of these came with 3¾-inch type figures. Now, a big help to the collecting sphere has been the weapons packs from Valaverse. And these have been hugely important for any G.I. Joe classified collector for getting sort of more realistic looking weapons for either display purposes or taking photographs with your figures. And when I saw that these were on sale, I just thought it was a good opportunity to get a different product and take a closer look at it. Now, when it came choosing between pack A or pack B, which I have here, I was kind of torn because there was one particular weapon in pack A that I really wanted, and that was a great looking Uzi, just to fill in the gap that I have of my Snake Eyes figure, because I've never really been able to find the proper Uzi accessory to go with that figure. And this one here had another weapon that drew me to it, and we'll open up the box and I'll show you what that is. Okay, so this is everything that's in weapons pack B. Now, you'll have to forgive me that I don't really know the names of a lot of guns. I'm into these purely for a fantasy perspective. And I'm going to go straight for this one here. And this was the big draw for me. And this is an M16, which is just so iconic from so many cool films back in the 80s, either Vietnam films or the A-Team. So as you can see, these are like a blank prototype style of figure that you can either paint up yourself or apply a bit of a brush or just use as is. But it was the M16 that really drove me to this pack, because it's just, like I said, one of those iconic ones from movies and TV from when I was younger. And another one then that caught my eye in this was, again, another M16 that has a bayonet at the end of it. So I suppose it was these two that drove me to go for weapons pack B instead of weapons pack A. Now, I'll just maybe bring the white box around, might be a bit clearer to see them if I put them out on that as I grab the next one. So you'll have to forgive me, I'm not going to be too up on my names for the rest of them. It also has this AK-47. Again, nice mouldings, and it's a nice firm plastic. Nice bit of detail in it, and it, like I said, blank that you can weather up yourself or apply any little details you want. What else have we got? We've got this machine gun here. A shotgun that has a peculiar butt at the end. Oh, that's one of the ones that opens out. Very cool. So there you go. Look, straight away you've got a replacement for your flint if you've missed out on the Valaverse ones. This machine gun here. This Uzi, which might just substitute in for my Snake Eyes figure, has a nice butt at the end of it. Again, one of the fold out butts. And then the last one in the pack is this more futuristic looking weapon. So overall, you get 8 different weapons. I think this retailed at $18.99, which is a little pricey, but then I suppose it works out cheaper than the Valaverse ones. Again, you get shipped over here. They, of course, have lovely paint apps, but these are blank. But it does open you to sort of customize them yourself, add a bit of a gray or silver wash for weathering, or a bit of brown if you wanted to sort of touch up some of the points on the gun. But really and truly, for me, it was all about just getting this classic looking M16. I'm sorry to keep showing this, I just think this is fantastic. The mags aren't removable, it's all molded together, and I think this is quite a nifty set. So a quick example here for a figure like Breaker that Hasbro released with no weapons whatsoever. A set like this is great for filling in that gap that you might have for a figure like that. And as you can see him standing here with the machine gun, it really does finish the figure off if you wanted to display this on a shelf or get this guy posed up for a photograph. And if, like me, you've been really infuriated by the fact that we still haven't got a good Snake Eyes with an Uzi, here's the classified holding the Uzi from the Mark2 Design Weapons Pack. Just posing the Cobra Infantry Trooper here with the AK-47, so if you weren't happy with the weapon that came with some of the Cobra figures, the AK-47 slots right into this guy, and he just looks so at home holding that sort of traditional bad guy weapon like an AK-47. Here I am trying out Desert Rat with the M16 assault rifle. Now I'm sure the gun that comes with this guy is far more up to date and advanced and more reliable than the M16 ever was, but just goes to show, with such an iconic looking gun like that, it really does add to any of your action figures. So that's been my quick look at the Mark2 Design Weapons Pack Set B that I got from Big Bang Comics here in Dublin. If you're interested in these, they have them on their website, and if you go on to bigbangcomics.com, you can see Weapons Pack A and Weapons Pack B and have a look at them there. There's also a website here on the packaging, Mark2Toys.com, where you might find more information. Now, $18.99 probably seems a bit steep for only 8 accessories. I didn't mind paying it because the accessories we got with the G.I. Joe classifieds were such a disappointment that if I was able to just replace out some of those with these designs here and make my displays or my photographs pop that bit better, to me, one pack of these was value for money. So I'm glad I picked it up. I'm really happy with them, and I'm glad I finally have an M16 to go along with my action figures. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. If you've got this far, you might consider dropping a like on the video, and please, if you feel like commenting down below, I love replying or chatting to people in the comments and getting to know people in the toy collecting community. I suppose, after all, that's why I do this. If you want to follow me over on Instagram, I post there fairly regularly as Fuller's Figures. And again, it's another spot to meet up or chat or talk to people in the community. But if nothing else, I hope I do see you the next time. Take care.